unfortunately for my speech that I've written, very few of you will know me. So I'm going to give you a wee bit of a history on my background. This place is special to me. I first attended here when I was 15 on a course. I think I should have been in an SFA course because it had more resemblance to a football with two legs than I had as a badminton player. I didn't look like a badminton player in those days. In fact, some say I've never looked like a badminton player, either on or off court. But if you can indulge me just for a minute and bear with me, I'll give you a brief, as I say, a brief history of myself and my history within the sport. Born 1936. money was scarce in the east end of Glasgow, the very rough upbringing. Well, my father was very rough with us. It wasn't a rough upbringing, he just battered us at every opportunity. That's what it seemed to be in my memory of my childhood anyway, although I did enjoy it. Not getting the batons, but I enjoyed all the other stuff. Parents were worried as usual about all the other stuff that exists, but in our day it was only drink, smoking and being a member of a gang. There was none of the drugs stuff or anything like that that's about just now. But my father had always told me I was special. He told my brother he was special. And indeed we attended a special school. But St Paul's was very special to me because that was where I was first introduced to sport. Fat as I was, I won the primary school sports trophy, which pleased my father no end, and put him on a quest to get me to represent my country and win millions of pounds for him and take him out of the area we lived in. Fortunately, he did that himself in his business, and I was left to move on to St Mungo's Academy, which was my secondary school. Sport was introduced to me there. It was of the rugby variety. I was in the last trial for the football team, and in the rugby team, I'd been selected for the rugby team. Front row prop, scrum leader, and I was the kicker in the rugby team. But final trials was coming up for the football. The PE teacher sent for me, told me he was withdrawing me for the football trials. He was keeping me for rugby because I was destined for great things at rugby. And whether he was right or not, I don't know, and we'll never know. But I did create a record for scoring points for a first year in school, which still exists. As I say, I was the kicker for the team, which isn't hard to rack up points when you're the kicker, but you've got to be pretty good, and I was pretty good at kicking. But unfortunately, it was just the ball I was kicking. But that's why I left rugby, because I didn't like when I was sent up to the sixth year school. St Mungo's had first and second and third year in one school, then they had fourth and fifth and then sixth year.